my name is Ray from the Natural Body Zone. And in this video, I will answer the question, how does weight loss work? Okay, now the concern to lose weight is something very recurrent in our current times. This not only involves self-esteem, but mainly the quality of life and health. Some factors responsible for overweight in adults include fast meals, little rest time, extra hours of work, and little space to worry about yourself, among others. If you would like to see my ultimate resource for healthy lifestyle, please click on the link in the description. And if you like my content, please support me by subscribing to my channel. So, how does the process to lose weight work? Well, understanding the process of losing weight means understanding how our bodies or your body's physiology works in terms of calorie consumption and storage. The metabolism acts in an individual way for everyone. Some processes the food in a faster way, while others with more difficulty being known as slow metabolism. This directly influences the energetic balance of the individual. Thus, food intake needs to be differentiated, as well as routine exercises and even the type of activity that will help in the process. Just remember that losing weight is a process that can happen by increasing caloric expenditure through exercise and/or by reducing calorie intake through diet. The famous phrase, "we are what we eat," is not so figurative nowadays. Much of what we eat can turn into bad calories for our body that allows accumulation of fat and weight gain. Our body cells are programmed to store energy, and they do this from what we eat throughout the day. So, a balanced diet does not only offer health benefits, it also offers good calories to be stored by the body. An overweight person has a reservoir of calories in the form of fat, much of what has been ingested and/or not spent. Adipose tissue or fat is the body's main energy reservoir. To counterbalance the way we feed the body uses this energy accumulated in the form of fat to perform the activities. However, these activities must be greater than the amount that the body uses only to keep doing the work. It is worth mentioning that your body will undergo significant metabolical adjustments for energy expenditure above the resting values. Thus, when the body performs lipolysis, breaking down the fat cells, it increases the concentration of free fatty acids that will be taken to the muscle to be used as an energy source for exercise. So know the cellular process that promotes fat burning, okay? So after eating a balanced diet and exercising, we usually lose weight. But what happens to the weight loss? According to the law of conservation of matter, nothing is created or destroyed, only transformed. In the same way, body fat does not disappear, but changes form. Knowing this process can be useful if you are looking to lose a few pounds. When you lose weight, the body converts the molecules of fat cells or lipocotes into usable energy. This is determined by the number of calories consumed, that is, the potential energy in food in the form of fats, proteins, or carbohydrates. A certain number of calories are consumed when digesting food. Once they have been broken down, the body uses the remaining energy or converts it into fat for storage in the lipocytes. To lose weight, you must burn more calories than you ingest and start using the fat reservoir. When eating, glucose and stored carbohydrate sugar are the first sources of fuel. The liver stores glucose as glycogen and releases it into the bloodstream as needed to maintain energy levels in the body. Once the glucose is depleted, fat begins to burn and a process called ketosis. Hormones that regulate blood sugar trigger an enzyme, lipase, that stimulates fat cells to release triglycerides. When they receive the lipase signal to leave the fat cells, the triglycerides break down into their respective components and enter the bloodstream. The liver absorbs the glycerol for energy. Once the cellular organs responsible for supplying the energy needed for cellular activity are activated, the glycerol compounds and fatty acids produce heat, water, carbon dioxide, and are carried to its potential energy to be used when we exercise. Water leaves our body in the form of sweat and urine, and we exhale carbon dioxide. Once the body has relieved the glycerol and fatty acids, they become smaller, reducing fat tissue and making the person look thinner. So this is how physical activities help in the process. Now, physical activities can be considered one of the most effective treatments for weight loss because it stimulates the increase in the activity of the somatic nervous system, or SNS, which allows the control of energy. The increase in energy consumption in response to the increase in SNS activity may have acted in reducing appetite, increasing the metabolic rate and rest, and greater action in fat oxidation. The human body works like a scale too. For the process to lose weight to happen, calorie expenditure must be greater than that consumed. This balance can be balanced by the diet, controlling food intake, as well as by increasing of the physical activity, or even by both, which when associated became very important allies. Thus, this mechanism only works after an evaluation by a good professional who will help you identify what needs to be motivated or modified or adjusted, and of course with physical activity to help in the process. So we need time to reach your goals, okay? It's necessary to know that whatever your objective, especially if it is to lose weight, takes time. No activity will result in significant weight loss overnight. The exercises should be included and altered according to your planning and adequacy. The metabolism of the body influences a lot in time to reach the goal. Some people have more facility to lose weight and others do not. Some have greater net retention, which can interfere with the result of the balance. What we need to understand is that each body has its own rhythm and does not depend on the level of exercise or the amount of activities you do. The caloric expenditure will vary as your body faces a certain series of sessions of physical activity. If you demand more energy to perform it, then the higher the caloric expenditure. Otherwise, your body will only consume what it is already used to and will have no impact on fat cells. So it is important to know your own body and how it loses or gains weight. But you can't escape the basic rule that you must expend more energy than you take in to do so. This is where my ultimate resource for a healthy lifestyle comes in. You can check it out by clicking on the link in the description below. And if you like my content and find it valuable, please support me by subscribing to my channel. And don't forget to ting the icon bell so that you are notified every time I release a new video when I release them. So cheers, and here's to your good health.